going to be more than a week of snowy weather and cloudiness, so I have two more panels, and just to make sure I've got enough power, I'm going to install them, because I don't want to run the generator when I've got two more panels here. And I probably need them when it's like this. They'll charge, but a lot less when there was sun. About 7 amps, that's pretty good. It's very cloudy. Wait, if I turn the inverter off, it's not using much. 7.6. Yeah, I can live with that. Yeah, this is really good. So it's a really cloudy day and it's charging 7 amps. So I probably don't use the generator at all. Like really only when it's snowing so much that I cannot keep the snow off, you know, because then it's not charging if it's covered with snow. Then I will have to use the generator. It's really when that's just an emergency. So this is good. Hear that? It's a wolf sound. Put the camera behind the house so you don't hear the river so much, the stream in the valley. It was very far away. Yeah, I'm not gonna put samples on them. Wolf samples. I hear so many YouTubers do that, or documentary makers on YouTube. And they've seen wolves and they put a sample underneath it to show. Because I know it's fake, because they always use the same sample. It's that one, it's from the Final Cut library. And it's also in that song, Night Call, from Kavinsky. You can look it up. They always use the same sample, so you know it's fake. I don't hear it anymore. Thank you. I was hearing the wolf very close. Oh man. I hope you can hear it. Oh man, that moon, that cloudy moon. My heart is pounding. It's the first time I heard so close the wolf. It's on the other side. It's far away still. I was just going up, I couldn't sleep. And I walked up the hill. I heard it very resonating in the valley, and wow, my heart was pounding. I've never heard a wolf so close. These are not samples, you know? It's just singing a song. He knows I'm here. I know he's there. He'll stay away. It's so beautiful. Wow. I mean, look at that moon. Yeah, you can't see it probably. It's too dark. It's a very hazy sky. And you can see the stars. The echo of the wolf sound is so beautiful. This is on the neighbor's land. They own these houses, but I've never seen people here. And they're not really inhabitable. They're a bit nicer, in a bit better shape than mine, but yeah, a lot of people in the valley, they own houses like this. They inherited because people lived in the mountains a long time ago. But yeah, they're not used anymore. You would say renovate them and have them as a holiday house or something like that, but people don't make the effort, or they don't want to invest because it costs a lot of money if you don't do it yourself, of course. And it's also because people are used to having these houses. When everybody has houses like this, it's not special, so they don't do anything about it. It's funny, isn't it? You just take it for granted. Well, it's a nice picnic spot for me. I come here often just for the view. It's about 300-400 meters from my house.
Is up on where the phone mast is. This will be still Pratostela, all the way up, from what I understand, to sort of where you come out of the big long corner.
Yeah.
And
so it's the house is what they've called Kjot Darlup, because Daniela, you translated it as a little place, a plain place. Other people, I read in the comments, they're saying it's the young of the wolf. So I wonder when it was called like that and what it means, where it comes from.
Well, I don't really have an answer for that. I just know the story that Romano, our neighbor.
Legends, they're all legends,
legends say, and this is the great thing about the mountains, because legends spring up and usually they involve wolves or something else. So in this case, the story goes that a mother who was living here with her family and everything, the mother was home with the child, but had to get water. The water you had to get from the little creek. And so she went in that direction and came back half an hour later. The child was gone, and presumably it was taken by wolf. So that's how Romano explained how it got the name.
It makes sense.
And he sort of did the Kjot, if I understood it correctly, the way he sort of interpreted it, it was connected to Kulla, which is the place where you put a child.
A basket.
A basket, or how do you say, a crib.
So this is where I get my water nowadays, because this is the main pipe is right over there, and it had frozen in January when there was not enough snow. So what they created is this overflow, so there's constantly a little bit of water going, because my pipe is frozen. Yep, I have to go up and down. vice is really nice. It's the first time I used it. I inherited it from my grandfather, who passed away this summer. It's very old, I think it's like 40 years old or something. Yeah, he was, he made model steam trains from recycled material. They were actually working steam engines. They're really, really beautiful little things. I made a portrait about him about 6 years ago, but I uploaded it on YouTube. It's, if you scroll down, it's the video before the first of this series. Nice. So that's how you cut threaded rod. First you put some bolts on there, you cut it, and then you unscrew the bolts so it cleans up the thread. I just googled that. Thank you, Google. Turn into a swamp. the day. Alright, so the boom is almost finished of the crane. I just fixed the dolly on it. The dolly I had already, I used it for videos. I think I made it like 10 years ago. You know, in the time when you didn't have the gimbaled steady cams, so you had a dolly for moving video shots. Winches on there. There's a few more things to be added, but mostly of the boom is finished. I'm waiting for a piece of steel from the steel guy in town. He's cutting a piece of steel because it's difficult to cut thick steel here. But I'll do the welding myself. I'll do that next week, and then I have to build the tripod, and then it's going to be finished. So it's all coming together, I think. Snow is gone. It was a nice day today. So yeah, I think the snow is coming back, but it's kind of like during the day it's warm enough, so it melts pretty quickly. So the weather is constantly changing, and the landscape, then it's like white and snowy, and now it's back to yellow and gray. So, alright, see you next week.